my channel, and today we are finally going to be doing my lock hair care wash day routine. Now you guys have been asking me for this for quite some time now, but hold the applause, the day is finally here, because a lot of people are always asking me about my hair, how I got it to get this long so quickly, how I got it to, like, you know, get this healthy as fast as I did. So I'm gonna actually give you guys some tips, but for future reference, I'm not gonna be doing many lock videos on this channel. I actually do a lot of my lock updates on my Instagram, so please make sure you go follow me on Instagram and make sure you peep the description box for more information that you guys constantly ask me about down below in the comment section. If you guys like my hoodie, it is part of my Media Hustle Creator merchandise shop. If you guys want a one-on-one consultation, stuff like that, you guys can also reference the shop for more things, because, you know, we be out here. So make sure you guys do that. There's also merchandise for this shop, and I do have a Haitian channel where I talk about Haitian things, folklore, politics, and things like that. So before we get started, a lot of you guys always ask me what I put in my hair and, you know, tips for hair growth. So we're just gonna get into that before we get into washing my hair and all of that. So first things first, my natural hair care routine videos can also be found on this channel. So if you don't have locks, you can still reference back to those videos. I still, for the most part, use the same things I used on my loose natural hair and do the same practices. A lot of people found me through my natural hair videos, dragging the natural hair community, going off about how people do so much to their hair and it's just absolutely not necessary. And this is because I feel like a lot of people are scammers. A lot of people will push products because they have affiliate links to them. A lot of people will push products just because they're sponsored. And a lot of people don't understand that it's not always about, you know, just genes and the fact that some people are lucky and some people sit here and they do a whole bunch of different regimens and hair care routines and challenges. Sometimes it's just about leaving your hair alone. I have a very no-nonsense, leave your hair alone approach to hair care. So if you think I'm about to, like, give you some, like, really super crazy secret to how I grew my locks long, if you think I have some crazy, ridiculous Haitian secret to how I grew my hair long, have some extensions I didn't tell you guys about, trust me, you're not gonna get that here. I didn't do anything but leave my hair alone. But there are some things that I think are unconventional that a lot of people might probably find wrong, but it is what it is. I really love my hair. It's great. It's been an amazing journey, and I never thought I would, like, love my locks as much as I do. I actually started my locks a while ago, like years ago, and I quit within like a month or two because I was like, no, I could not get through the ugly phase. And I know a lot of people in the lock community do not like that word. I don't give a shit. For me, I didn't like the way I look when my locks were shorter. And now I kind of embraced it, but honestly, for me, what I did was I wore a lot of head wraps and I wore wigs over them. But this time, I really got into wearing braids over my locks. A lot of times where you guys saw me wearing braids, I thought I quit. Part of the reason my locks grew so long was because I literally just braided them. I went to the regular shop that I always got my braids done at, the African shops, okay? And I told them, braid my locks. And as you guys can tell, my locks are pretty thick. They're actually pretty old now. I actually had perm rods in them. Pretty damn good, you know? And usually when I wash them, they get a lot thicker. But when they're styled, if they're curled, whatever the case may be, they get a little bit thinner. But it doesn't, like, thin out forever. It's like a temporary thinning type of effect. But realistically, people think that when you get locks, like, you're kind of, like, locked down to just having locks and lock styles. You can still put rollers in them. You can still get braids. You can still put a wig over it. Shout out to Chanel. She's the girl who does my locks. I will put her information right here. I'll link it down below. She's in Newark, New Jersey. She literally has been putting wigs over her locks forever. Okay, she just took her locks out now, but she was literally doing it for a minute. You can literally put wigs over your locks. You're not just confined to having locks. And that was my first mistake when I first had locks. I was just like, oh my God, no. Like, I don't want to go through that phase. Da, da, da. And I understand why a lot of people don't like calling it the ugly phase or whatever. But to be honest, if you're not comfortable with something, you're not confident about something, if, you know, if you have to put wigs over it, if you have to put, you know, whatever it is over it, so be it. I prefer the braids though. And I feel like that definitely helped my locks grow because it was not being touched. Just like with my loose hair, I do not touch my locks for shit. I do not moisturize my hair on a regular basis. I do not wash my hair frequently. I do not do anything in terms of manipulating my hair. Now, when it came to my loose textured hair, I wet it a lot. I washed my hair probably like every week, okay, at the minimum. When I first went natural, I probably washed my hair every day at one point. That's just how my loose hair was. It was very, very, like, dry. It would get dry quickly and it didn't retain moisture. So I kind of had to, and my hair would either flourish by either leaving it alone completely, or if I had it out, I'd have to wet it continuously. So it was either one or the other. If it wasn't in braids and if it wasn't under a wig or whatever, I had to either leave it completely alone or
or wet it all the time. With this, I just leave it alone. So for the most part, if I am going to moisturize, which I rarely do, I'll put in a leave-in conditioner. And this is my go-to leave-in conditioner. A cream of nature. As you guys can see, I really do use it because it's tatted up. I actually get this from Dollar General. I probably spray this in my hair twice a month. So a lot of you guys are probably curious, how long have you had your locks? It's been a year and maybe 4 to 5 months. I believe August made it a year since I fully had my locks. Again, you really see the length more when it's washed. When it's freshly washed, that's when you really see the length. Next thing is this cleansing water. Barely use this. I actually was sponsored by Dark and Lovely for this, but this is when I still had my loose textured hair. But I actually still use this sometimes if my hair is like really, really dirty due to product. You guys ever have like a buildup product situation? Or like if you have a situation where like your scalp is just always itchy, you have dandruff, whether it's braids, locks, any type of style, this right here is it. But again, barely use it. It's at least halfway full. The next thing that I use, always tried and true, literally since I was a baby, Haitian castor oil. Now this bottle you can get from Amazon. I've been using this since I had loose textured hair as well. Haitian castor oil is the best. I also use Indian castor oil as well when I don't have Haitian castor oil. The reason I don't use Jamaican castor oil is because personally I don't think it does much for me. It's not the same. All castor oil is not made the same. Haitian castor oil, it hit different. This is literally the only thing I can say I put in my hair more than anything that I have that I will tell you guys about, next to the leave-in conditioner. These two things work hand in hand. These two things I put in my hair probably twice a month. You guys are probably like, bro, you're joking. I do not moisturize my hair regularly. I can't stress this enough. If you leave your hair alone, I guarantee you it will grow. Even if you sitting here and someone's like, oh, well, my hair be dry, my hair used to be very dry too. If it was in a style, I would leave it alone. But if it was out, that's when I would manipulate it and stuff. But I find that in this type of situation right here, when it came to my locks, leaving it alone is what's best. If for whatever reason I run out of this, I do use this leave-in conditioner. This is the Cream of Nature Pure Honey Breakup Breakage Leave-In Conditioner. I really like this stuff. It is thicker than this one. This one is more watery. This one is like more of a cream leave-in conditioner. As you guys can see, like it doesn't even go anywhere when you put it upside down. I like this, but I personally like this more when I get out the shower. Since it's thicker, it kind of stays in more, but I don't like the fact that it leaves like that white cast on your hair. But it does like last a lot longer in my hair because it's thicker. My hair does better with like creamier type of leave-in conditioners, and it smells a lot nicer. This was recommended to me by my stylist, okay? And even though I recommended this to y'all, the leave-in conditioner, you would think, okay, Ivana, you use the leave-in, the shampoo should be amazing. Everybody swears by this stuff, right? This is the Queen of Nature with Argan Oil from Morocco, sulfate-free moisture and shine shampoo. I thought, okay, this is gonna be amazing. Let me tell y'all, my hair don't like this shit. I ran out of my Aussie shampoo and conditioner last time I was washing my hair, right? So I've used this stuff since I had loose textured hair. I ran out. So I tried to use this because I just had it on hand. This shit made my hair itch like hell. I don't know what it is that's in here that my hair don't like. I'm definitely allergic to something in here. As soon as I got out the shower, my head was itching. I'm sitting in the chair to get my hair done. My head is itching. I don't know why my hair doesn't like this stuff. I don't know what's in here that my hair doesn't like. I don't care. I cannot use this. And I know a lot of people who have locks that use this shampoo and they swear by this, but this shit right here, trash for me. I actually went and picked up some new ones. This is the Total Miracle 7-in-1 Conditioner Revite. I can't say that word. They didn't send me to college to know how to read clearly. And this is the Total Miracle Shampoo with apricot and Australian macadamia oil, paraben free. But I'm sure these definitely have sulfates. Yeah, both of these are apricot. Now, I ain't never tried these. I really hope Aussie don't let me down because Walmart didn't have my regular Ultra Moist. And I'm really mad because as you guys can see, there's a difference in the size of the fucking bottle. This one is 865 millimeters. This one is 778. I kid you not, I will return this shit with a fucking swiftness. I am the return queen. I am a Karina. Okay, so we are gonna try this. This is gonna be new, but I've been using like the same Aussie for maybe about 5 to 6 years. I'm not joking. You guys are probably wondering, how often do you wash your hair? How often should you wash your hair? I feel like it's up to you. When you're first starting your locks, it's an extremely bad idea to be out here washing your hair on a regular basis. You should wash your hair like literally when you're about to get a retwist. That's about it. So if you're gonna get a retwist every month, you should wash your hair once a month. Personally, I only wash my hair once a month, maybe twice a month if I have to. And you guys are like, oh my God, that's that's dirty. Why would you? My hair smells amazing. My hair is perfect. My hair is actually rarely ever dirty at all. It's so interesting because like I'll literally be looking to see like if dirty water runs through the shit and it's like, no, it's perfectly fine. But in between washes, I actually do use dry shampoo. I never thought that dry shampoo ever had a purpose in my life, but it does. And the dry shampoo that I do use is the Dove dry shampoo. This is the Care Between Washes with charcoal for days when washing is not part of the planned but beautiful hair is. Clarifying dry shampoo. I love this stuff. I just spray, massage. And then this is where I use this. Sometimes I use this. I've been using this since I had relaxed hair. Like my mom put me onto this stuff. It is the Salon Pro Argan Oil from Morocco Hair Food, Hair and Scalp Nourishment. This is really good, especially if you have like itchy scalp. So then I'll go in with this, and then that's when I'll go in with this leave-in, and then I'll go in with my Haitian castor oil, of course. And yeah, it's done. It's usually like a 30-minute process, and it will literally last me a good 2 weeks. Like, I kid you not. Like, my hair will be smelling good. It is perfect, especially when like you're literally on the go, you have somewhere to be, you know, you got a little appointment, you think your hair is a little crusty smelling. Perfect. Like dry shampoo, it's amazing. I don't know why I didn't discover this stuff sooner. Like clearly if you have loose texture, natural hair, it doesn't really make sense for you to be using dry shampoo. I really don't think. I don't know. Comment down below if you have loose texture, natural hair, and you use dry shampoo, because I really feel like that shit probably, there's no way. I don't think I would ever put that shit on my loose textured hair. But for this, it works because you're only putting it on your scalp. So it's not necessarily like really touching your ends. And you know, when it does, you know, go to the ends, like it just makes it smell good. And any type of like, you know, dandruff or any type of product buildup, it just, you know, comes out and yeah, it just gets your life together. When you condition, you should always condition your roots, not your ends. Just focus here. Okay, don't be like, you know, how you would with your loose natural hair, do all of that. No. Just focus it on your scalp because that's where your hair is growing from, right? But I feel like that's what you should do with your loose textured hair too. I feel like too many people focus on, you know, their ends because, you know, oh my God, I want the curly. Yeah, but that hair is dead, okay? Even here, like all of this is dead. All of this, you know, all that goodness. The whole conditioning debate is ridiculous. I know people that really don't condition their hair at all. And I'm like, well, that's probably why your scalp is dry as fuck and it's flaking all the time because you don't condition it. You should always condition your hair. I do not deep condition whatsoever. If I do deep condition, it's probably I did have something dehydrating in my hair. Like there's been rare times where like my stylist has put something in my hair, like she tried something new and it's like it really irritated my scalp, or like I really didn't wash my hair in a really long time, or like I went to the beach and the sand dehydrated my hair, something like that. It's the very rarest time that I've ever deconditioned my hair, and I probably count on one hand how many times I deconditioned my hair since my hair's been locked. I don't do that, but I do regularly condition and I do use leave-in condition. So there you have it. My very simple lock routine for ultimate hair growth, okay? Personally, I don't believe in putting a whole bunch of bullshit in your hair. I just don't think it's very necessary. You know, like now that my hair is getting longer, I could finally like, you know, oh my God, yeah, a little ponytail. Oh my God. Oh shit, it's actually a real ponytail for real now. You know, so now I can actually do stuff. So like before, I couldn't really do all of that. So I kind of just like let go and let... But I absolutely love my hair. Like every day I wake up, I'm like, I fucking love it. But it's an amazing process. So let's start washing. Now we're about to hop in the shower, take a shower, as well as wash my hair. So I like to section my hair off when it comes to washing my locks. When it came to my loose natural hair, I usually did that only if my hair was specifically dirty. But when I wash my locks, I almost always do this because it just makes the process easier. Especially as my hair has gotten longer. It is way too much going on when your hair is going here, your hair is going there, and it's going all around. It's going to town. You don't want that. I've wasted so much of my money on these hair clips. I only have one left, and as you guys can see, it kind of broke on one end. So I said, fuck that, kill that noise. So now I just use hair ties, okay, in order to section off my hair. They're different, they're a lot stronger, they do not snap at all. I've had these for years. They also don't really rip your hair out per se like many other hair ties, and that is the best way I see to deal with this. When your hair is shorter, you don't necessarily have to do this, to be honest with you. You really could just wash and go. The reason I didn't like sectioning off my loose hair is because personally, I just never thought it was necessary. And my hair never tangled when it was wet. I know a lot of people with their loose natural hair, it tangles and it just becomes like a lot for them. My hair doesn't tangle at all. So like as soon as we get wet, it was easier for me to manage. So I never felt the need to sit there and do all of that. So perfect life. Now I know a lot of people are gonna comment, oh my God, how many locks do you have? I can't even tell you, I don't know. I never kept count, I really don't care.
But I can tell you the locks in the back of my head are definitely less. That's cause the hair in the back of my head is definitely thinner, so.
This is probably not an even section, but does it really matter though? As long as it is sectioned off. Sometimes
I'm real lazy and I only do like 3 parts, all right? So now that I have my sections, we're gonna get in the shower. So we are now out of the shower. As you guys can see, that literally, well, honestly, I'm sure it was sped up because Milagros probably sped the whole thing up. Good thing for editors, good thing for editing. But honestly, washing my hair, just like my loose textured hair, only takes me about 30 minutes tops. I know you guys are probably wondering about shedding, and here we are. Very minimal. I did not clean anything up. No shedding, virtually no shedding at all. My hair does not shed. Now, I will say that when you first start your locks, it might shed a little bit. That's because your hair is not locked yet. Again, do not be out here washing your hair, manipulating your hair, touching hair a lot when it is not locked. It will unravel, it will be a hot ass mess. And if you have hair like mine where it's really, really soft, it's just, you're gonna end up having to get it instant locked. You're gonna have to do a whole bunch of shit to get it to cooperate, and you're not gonna want that. So now we're going to do my little 10 minute situation, probably gonna take 5. So we're gonna go in with leave-in conditioner and my Haitian castor oil. Like I said, you will be able to see the full length when it's washed. That's, you know, almost about the same when it comes to loose natural hair as well. I love it. My goal by the end of the year is to be able to grab my hair like this. I'm almost there. I can grab it, but I can't grab it. I wanna be able to like, argh. So definitely a little bit longer.
I love my hair so much, y'all.
Sadly, since I really have poofy hair and your natural texture will always dominate what your locks look like, when my hair starts to dry, it will poof up, but it won't be that bad. What you can do to combat this, depending on your hair texture and if you really don't want that to happen, you can tie it down with a do-rag, something that's gonna have it like tight so that it doesn't poof up as badly. I don't typically do that, but my boyfriend does that a lot and it really, really helps him. But he has like really soft hair anyway, so I don't even understand why he's doing it. Let's get into this whole situation right here. So first we're gonna do leave-in conditioner. Ooh. You guys are probably like, what is all this white stuff? I put lotion on, y'all. Put lotion on me while I'm still wet. Eczema problems, if you know, you know. Gotta lock in that moisture. So I go in with the leave-in and my hands are very slippery. You know, I have no idea how I'm about to do this. This is about to be, I mainly aim for the scalp. I really focus in the middle of my head because for whatever reason, it's always itchy and dry here. This is where my bald spot was. You guys did not watch that story of how one of my friends gave me a bald spot. So to this day, still hurts. It's been like, what, 7 years? Oh wow, way more than seven. Maybe 9 years since that happened and it still hurts like hell. Haitian castor oil. Now, for as many times as I wash my hair, I actually wash my hair 3 times. I do 2 pumps the first time, 1 pump the second and third time. When I separate the segments, I wash it 1 time, then a second time, then I let everything together, and I wash it a 3rd time altogether with everything, you know, unseparated, unless it's really that dirty, then I keep everything separated the entire time. Now with this, I just go in on each segment. It's so sad because there's nothing there, but it's still always irritating the hell out of me. I'm getting my hair done tomorrow. I'm sure she's still gonna wet my hair a little bit, but I'd rather get washing it out of the way today. Sometimes I'll wash it like right now. Like say if I was going to get it done like in an hour or two and then I'll go. I'm probably gonna get my nails done tomorrow. I was gonna get it done today. You want to make sure everything is distributed. You don't want to go too heavy with this because not only is this heavy, but it does not smell the most pleasant. It doesn't stink, but it's not like roses and butterflies. It don't got that, you know, urban botanical smell, bro. And as you see, it's a very thick oil. It's not something that you really want to saturate your whole head in. Be very careful. Make sure you get all your edges. This is really good for those of you guys who like, your edges get pulled a lot, if you like to wear your hair in ponytails. Okay. You guys are probably wondering where to get Haitian castor oil. Ask your Haitian friends. Find a Haitian store that sells like Haitian convenience stuff. Usually they'll have it in the back or something, but most importantly, just ask a Haitian. They'll probably point you in the right direction. There's some Haitian people that sell it online, but it's ridiculously expensive for no reason. So it's best to just find a local Haitian store. We're done. And I leave my life and I leave it alone until it's time to get done. And then I leave it alone for another month until it's time to do this all over again. So with that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Let me know what your lock tips are. How long have you had locks? What do you think about my locks? You love them, you hate them, whatever. Also, make sure you guys follow me on Instagram because I will be doing more little updates on there. And when I get my hair done, you guys are going to be able to see it on there. So of course, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you guys peep the description box and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.